You know it's going to be a weird video when you start off by dry stripping.
We're going to be doing a back workout, back and arms, with some deadlifts in the back workout. Because I want to see what I can deadlift. Because I was meant to deadlift last week, but I crashed my car and I fucked up my neck and my head. But now it's a week later and I'm good. So this video, we're going to do workout tonight. Show you what I eat post-workout, what I do at night, whatever. Tomorrow, full day of eating. So there'll be two videos getting released in 2 days.
So that was a fucking lie.
So me being the big numpty that I am, I've been forgetting to record today. I was meant to do a full day of eating, but it's already 2 or 3 o'clock. I don't know. But, so we're just going to film another workout video. And, turn into a bit of a vlog. I don't fucking know. I don't know what I can do. I don't do anything. Locked down and shit. I don't fucking know. Let's get in the workout. I'm just rambling again. Alright, so this can be a bit more of an in-depth video. So, as always, want the shoulders. Training chest and shoulders. Shoulders and chest today. Starting off with the shoulders. No matter what, every single day I do side lateral raises. Every single day. Not heavy. Just start off by doing side laterals. Pushing some blood into the shoulders, getting them moving, and then I do rotation work, and then, yeah, we'll see how I go from there. But always, daily, every day, doing this sort of shit, just to help warm up so I don't injure myself. So I've been training a lot more intense lately. And that's mainly because I'm trying to put on as much size as possible. I'm starting to not fuck around as much, starting to take it a bit more seriously. Getting some of these. Hearing all kinds of crunch action in your shoulders when you do these ones. Oh, feels good all the time. And then shoulder presses. Quick, little controlled shoulder presses. You might be thinking, hey, that's only 1 kilo, that's fuck all, but after doing everything that I just did, your muscles are kind of already worn out a little bit. I just dropped a 1 kilo weight and it's fucking smacked me straight in the ankle. Like, oh, focus. You can't see it. Doesn't look that bad, but fuck, it hurts. So we're gonna be attacking this workout with a hell of a lot of intensity. If you don't work out with intensity, then you can't expect to grow. If you don't hit failure, don't expect to grow. If you don't push yourself, don't expect to grow. Because muscles learn over time, body adapts, becomes harder. So you need to surprise it and Shock of the muscle, as Arnold says.
So, we're going to be starting off relatively light. Just got the 15 pounders out. We're just going to be doing side laterals with these. But we're going to be doing a fuckload of side laterals. Like, I mean, literally, probably 7 sets, 8 sets. Crazy amount. Every time you do a set, go up in weight. 2.5 pounds. And since you're thinking, oh, 2.5 pounds each set, that's not that much. By the end of the set, by the end of the whole exercise, you're gonna be doing 2.5 times 7. So every single set, you're going to want to go up by a little bit. Tap into that progressive overload. Go up as high as you can. Last set, I kind of want to be fucking around with like the 30s, 35s, pounders, not kilos. So what's that? Like 15 kilos. All right, so moving on to the next set, going up in weight, always going up in weight. What's it called? Progressive overload. You want to be trying to abuse that as much as you can. That is where you make all your gains. You don't make your gains from doing the same weight over and over and over again. So, you just want to keep on doing different shit. Because you never want your body to adapt and become used to what you do. So my mentality for the workouts are, don't be a bitch and lift some weight. I don't like hearing people say, oh no, we're not weightlifters. We're not powerlifters. We shouldn't be lifting heavyweight. We're bodybuilders. We're meant to be building muscle and doing repetitive reps. Nah, fuck that. Repetitive reps, heavyweight, that's how you build big muscle. Ronnie Coleman, Dorian Yates, Seth Ferrosi, Arnold, Tom Platz. You can name more. I could name more, but I'm not going to go on because that's just going to be me rambling. So, they all built their muscle through lifting heavy weight, squatting heavy weight, deadlifting heavy weight, shoulder pressing heavy weight, heavy lateral raises, heavy bench press, all that sort of shit. And there's a reason why they're pros. It's because they train like that and they train with intensity. So I've taken what they've learned, smashed it all together, put it into one, and fucked it. Made a baby out of it. So that's how I train. Woo! Okay. 25ers. Also, when you get to your last set, so when you get to your 30s or your 35s or whatever your last set is, as soon as you put your weights down, put them in, drop the weight, do another set. Drop the weight, do another set. Drop the weight, do another set. And go all the way back to what you started with. So 30 pounders for the last set. Then we're gonna go 30, 25, 22, 20, 17, 15. So it's gonna be a rather long set. Man, all right, so after that 3 minute set, my shoulders are fried. So gonna have about a 2 minute rest time and then we're gonna move on to dumbbell shoulder presses. Nothing too hectic, not heaps of weight. Probably couldn't do heaps of weight because of what the fuck I just did, but just get there and when I do shoulder press, I don't extend all the way up and I don't come down to 90 or below 90. Well, I'll go to 90, I'll go to here, but you won't see me ever really go past there. I'll just do the top two-thirds like this, because I believe that puts more tension on my shoulders than my joints. And also, when you're up here and you extend it all the way, you're hitting triceps, not shoulders. So I believe it's more beneficial to only do, is it the bottom or the top? I say the bottom two-thirds of the rep. But yeah, so let's get into this exercise. Make sure you stay hydrated during this workout, because you are going to sweat like a motherfucker, especially if you've taken a pre-workout, such as Primeval Cuts. The reason why I take a cutting pre-workout, even when I'm bulking, is kind of because it helps me to stay lean, or so I think it does. I like the feeling of it. It doesn't have as much caffeine as other pre-workouts. But the reason why I choose Primeval Labs, excellent taste. If it doesn't taste right, doesn't taste good, you shouldn't be fucking drinking it. Really good ingredients. Like quality ingredients, they look after you. And they actually care for the customer. They're not just there to make money. And three, I like them as a company. I think they're really good. So go check them out. Use code NAFE10. On their website, links in my bio on my Instagram account, use it and help a brother out. I need heavier dumbbells. See, I ripped out 20s for 20. I can't wait for commercial gyms to open back up. That'll be a happy day. So another way you can increase your intensity during a workout is doing like pause reps. So that when you're repping out on a set, you pause at the bottom of the set, but you keep on working out with the other arm. So it's like a pause rep on one hand and a continuing to work out on the other, but then you switch sides after two reps. So yeah, as I was saying, that's a really good way to increase intensity. It just adds another variable into the workout. If you've never done it before, because you're pausing at the bottom of the rep where your muscle is under the most tension. So time under tension is muscle growth. More muscle growth equals more muscle, obviously, but it's just the way it works. It's just, if you don't have the weights, like you don't have enough weight, then there's other variables you can add in there to make it so that the weight is heavier, harder, more intense. So you don't always need to lift heavier. But good old saying, there's no replacement for displacement, so no replacement for extra weight. But yeah, just extra variables you can add in to your workout. So now we're moving on to seated front deltoid raises. So the way I like to do these, you bring it up and you hold your hand at a 45 degree angle when you're doing them, and you like to feel as if you have a little tiny itty bitty ball, like a little ball in here, and you're trying to squeeze the fuck out of it against your pec and your front delt. So you're really doing, bringing it across. But when you've got the weight there, you're tensing up your front delt to try and squish that ball against your pec. And so with the hand on the angle, it's going to be using more deltoid than chest. And I like to come, so arms straight out, and when I go down, I like to hold it so I'm not directly at the bottom of the rep, so that I'm a little bit further forward to keep the tension on, because otherwise I'd be doing it on cables. And now you're going to be supersetting it with bent over rear delt raises. So that's the superset for this workout, for shoulders at least. So exactly how you think, just bent over, legs straight out like this. Oh, straighter out than normal, how you'd be sitting. You have the dumbbells here, I like to keep my hands parallel with the floor, and you're doing the top 3/4 of the rep to keep the tension on. And don't bend over too far, because otherwise you'll be hitting more back than you will shoulders. So now we're moving on to rear deltoid rows. So you're gonna wanna be standing, not like in a row state, like not bent over like this, but instead more standing upright, so that when you row, and you don't wanna row down to your hip, because that'd be using your lat. You wanna be rowing up like 90 degrees, so that you're using your upper back and your rear deltoid. So you're putting more emphasis on the rear delts. This is a very good, it's good for packing on size onto your upper and deltoids, rear deltoids. Upper back and rear deltoids, I mean, English. Now, it's okay to get a bit of body language into this, so it's okay to get a bit of swing going. As long as your back's straight, you stay safe, you do whatever, get some body language into it so you can move a tiny bit more weight. I use the 20s for it, and by the time I've done 4 sets of these, my rear delts up. We're doing reverse progressive overload. I forgot what it's fucking called. We're going down the pyramid of weight rather than up. So we're starting off at the heaviest for my first set. So, and then next set will be lighter, set after that will be lighter, and set after that will be lighter. But when you're doing this, you need to keep the intensity high, because you're not working up on weight, you're staying at the same. So as soon as you get up, change those weights. As soon as the weights are changed, you get back down on that bench and you start repping. Get up. Take a weight off. And then get straight back into repping. So now that I've pyramided all the way down, I'm gonna be putting some more weight back on. And we're gonna be doing another set like that. Because what? That was 3 sets in the span of about 3 minutes. So this really gets the blood flowing. Don't forget to hydrate. Otherwise you will die a painful, slow, dehydrated death. And trust me, that doesn't sound like fun. So this will push your intensity up through the roof. This will make your pecs scream at you. Alright, so now, moving on to the last exercise. I don't do much for my chest because my chest just grows. It's where I'm naturally gifted. It just fucking, I do bench press, incline press, and it just grows. I don't have to do much for it. So now we're moving on to the last exercise, doing dumbbell bench press. Now, I don't have much weight, so what I'm gonna do is slow pause reps. So power on the way up and really slow on the way back down, and then pause at the bottom for 3 seconds and then back up. And that's gonna add intensity. So for each exercise, you're going to want to be hitting around 4 to 5 sets of each. And for reps, stay within the 10 to 15 mark. But of course on the first set, varied, did like 7 sets of lateral raises. But that's just variables that you can add into your workout to add more intensity. Like pause reps, slower reps, I don't know what the fuck they call pause reps while you're working out with the other arm. Just variables to add in to make the workout more intense, to make it more the way you want it to be. So that'll be it for this workout. But I'm gonna keep on recording for the day, get some food in, because I forgot to record the rest of the day's food. Because I'm a fuckwit, but so yeah. Let's go eat. Welcome to the Pantry of Gains. So, I'm feeling a bit lazy, so I'm thinking about just smashing in a shake, and not just a normal shake, a Gainer shake, a homemade Gainer shake. With about 1500 calories in it. You eat this boy, this boy. So you eat this bad boy post-workout, trust me, you're gonna be making nothing. The sweet gains. So, I recently got this new shit that everyone's been raving on about. Powdered peanut butter. Heaps of protein, no fat, no carbs, so gains all day, every day. So, gonna need oats, a banana, which I'll grab in a second, protein. I can't wait for my bloody package to get here. I'm sick of having this shit. I don't even know if it's a good brand or not. It was just in the chemist. Even though I ordered my protein like fucking like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Australia Post being shit. But that's life, I guess. Boom. Cup. Where's the milk? Yes, we do. We do indeed have milk. So, 600 milliliter milk. Which is a lot of milk, I won't lie. 100 grams of oats, which I've roughly estimated to be 1 cup. Now, to make this all fit into here, you'd think, fuck, there's no room left in here. Give it a bit of a, one of them. Let it sit, and boom, look, all the oats sink. Get your banana. Now, you can put it on with the skin in, it's just gonna have a funny taste. Just a warning. I've never used this shit before. 55 calories a serving, 1.7 grams fat, 5.7 protein, 3.5 grams carbs. How much should I use? I want about 200 calories from it. So 200 calories, what's 13 times 4? 52 or some shit. Yeah. This was like 10 bucks too. Fucking crazy. I like peanuts. Come on. 20. 30. 40. 51, close enough. I don't think I'm gonna cry about 1 gram. I'm actually, we're only gonna have one scoop of protein because that's got 20 grams in it, that peanut butter. So, excellent. Less bad tasting, non-mixing, same consistency protein. Now, when I tell you guys about proteins and all the rest of that shit, like supplements, I only give information about the better supplements, ones that I would actually use. I'm not out here to say, ooh, give me money, give me money. No, I'm here to actually entertain you, provide you with information that you want. And, of course, hopefully help to better you people. So when I find something that I like and I think's good, I tell you guys.